Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us learn about the interfacing output display. So this is a 7-segment display, guys. Guys, I think every one of you visited at least once railway station, guys. I'll be most commonly observing this LED kind of displays in railway stations and even in some digital watches, which kids used to wear. When we are kids, we used to wear those LED watches, which indicates the number like this, guys. It will be having some bars. I'll be just drawing you a rough diagram. 4, 5, 6, and 7. There will be some bars like this. If all of them are on, it shows it is 8. If only this 1, 2, 3 are on, it shows 7, like that. Using this LED, only from 0 to 9 all numbers are indicated, guys. So if there are multiple, if there are two like this, you can indicate from 00 to 99. Like that, according to the number of LEDs segment increases, you can show different numbers. So the 7-segment LEDs are most popular display devices used for single board microcomputers. Even for microprocessor on 8085 kit, we will be having this way of representation, guys, of address, which I think every one of you know that. Okay, so the 7-segment LED display can be either common anode type or common cathode type. According to diagrammatically, they seem almost similar, guys, but there will be small changes. So first let us draw the cathode 7-segment LED. So just draw a box, draw this representation of 8 with cuts. Fine. So start writing numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fine. And now start placing ABCDs. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay. So those are the 7 letters. And in between, the third point will be CO, that is nothing but common cathode. And 8th point will also be CO, that is nothing but common cathode. And at 6 it is DP, that is nothing but dot or decimal point, guys. Fine. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on the cathode representation. If you want to represent that in terms of a scale, or what we will be calling this, guys, I think mostly we will be calling it as a scale. Okay, let me check it out once. So that we will be calling as internal connections, it seems, guys. So the internal connections will be something like this. They will be like this. Okay. So this points towards this side. Okay. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on cathode 7-segment. So anode 7-segment, the diagram of the first pin configuration is exactly same, where the internal connections, this is completely reversed, guys, that is flipped, so that you will be getting a symbol like this. So in place of these symbols, we will be having these symbols. That's it, guys. So that's the only difference from common cathode to common anode. So I hope everyone got a small idea. Okay, guys, sorry for that interruption. So now let us continue our lecture. So basically, in that, we previously we discussed the how the cathode and anode 7-segment display looks like. So now let us go in detail through it, guys. Okay, so basically cathode segment, and we are having anode segment also, guys. So this symbol and number from 0 to 9, yes, this symbol can represent from 0 to 9 on this LED. So if we want to represent 0, only the outer layer. If you want to represent 1, only this end layer or this end layer. So this end layer will be the best option. So like that, we can denote them. So I forgot to say you about this numbering, guys. So okay, sorry for that, guys. So the numbering will be like this: A, B, C, D, E, F, and in center G. Got it? We'll be rotating the whole clockwise, and at the end we come into the center. So that's how A, B, C, D, E, F, G will be coming. Fine. So now let us go through these two pictures, guys. I'll be opening my material so that you'll be having a detailed idea. Just give me a second. Okay, so when we are doing for cathode, so let me write the points, guys, so that it will be clear for you. Okay, A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So if we want to represent zero, yeah, we want to represent zero, so we are doing in cathode, right? So remember, in cathode we represent the active ones with one, guys. So here there should be note. Okay, here we'll be having decimal point, guys, so there is no need for decimal point. So that's the reason why dp is equals to 0, and we also no need g, so g equal to 0. So other all f e d c b a, they all should be one. Fine. Okay, so once you wrote this in this order, the first separate the first 4 bits into one and the next 4 bits into one. So I think everyone can convert the binary to hexadecimal, guys. So this is nothing but 2 to the power of 0 plus 2 to the power of 1, that is nothing but 3. So we got 3, and all ones is nothing but 15, that is nothing but F. So in that way we can convert each and every binary code into hexadecimal code, guys. So that's how this table is completely filled with different numbers. So just give me a second, guys. Okay, so similarly the table for anode is right here. So anode will be completely opposite to that. So in anode, if it is active, we will be representing it with 0. If it is not active, we'll be representing it with 1. That's it. That's the only difference, and the calculations will be doing the same way, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So if you are interested, we can take an example on this, guys, so that you'll be having a clear idea. Okay. So let me open my book. I have just written an example. So to display 8 on the LED, what we should do? Move A comma 08H. Fine. So 8, guys, what will be the order? So DP, G, F, E. Okay, this is what we are writing. Is that the order correct, guys? So this should be the first part and this will be the second part, right? Okay, so but in this case we assumed that DCBA as first part and this as second part. So from here we got D0, D1, D2, 3, D3, 4, D5, D6, D7. So here this represents 0 and this one represents 8. So 2 power 3 is nothing but 8. So like that we got 0, 8. So if we substitute the opposite to that here. Okay, guys, just give me a second. Okay, this is the representation of 8. And this is the address representation where we need to show our output. So that address is nothing but F5. So that's what we have just denoted here. So this is how you'll be for solving the examples, guys. Just you'll be writing for 08 what you want to display, that code, and the output code in terms of addresses and this in terms of data. That's it. So if you want to know the exact circuit diagram of this connected with the interfacing input, so this will be the circuit diagram, guys. If you want, you can just go on Google and search for it, guys. You'll be getting many images like this. Okay, if you want, I'll be searching in my book and I'll be showing it in the book, guys, so that in book it's really clear, but when I just took a copy of that, it became really blur. Okay, fine, this is the diagram, guys. Okay, let me remove this book. So this is the diagram. Here it is multiplexed with this cathode or anode, guys, according to the requirement. So the rest of the circuit is already we learnt it. That is nothing but interfacing input device circuit, guys. Still here. Fine. So I hope everyone got a small idea on the cathode and anode representation of LED 7-segment display. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through interfacing input device. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.